We know you have seen the reviews on the new Verna Turbo, but that car is priced at an astonishing 13.99 lakh rupees ex showroom, which is quite a hefty price tag for a sporty Hyundai.
So realistically, if you're looking to buy the new Verna, you're going to look at this the most. This is the Verna SXO, and this is the top spec model that you can get in the range, except from the turbo, of course. So today, let's find out if it's any good. So let's get a few differences out of the way. Even if this looks like a completely new model from the front, it's actually just a facelift. Hyundai have analyzed the aftermarket trends for the Verna, and they observed and they found out that people are buying these big black honeycomb grills for it. So instead of making people buy it from the aftermarket, they've just integrated that design language into the OEM look. And I have to say, it looks really, really good. I mean, the last Verna that was there, it was okay-ish looking for me. It was not my favorite, but this actually looks like business. And with that, you also get a new headlight design and also a new bumper.
Hyundai have retained the overall silhouette for the Verna, and you can clearly see that they've gone for swooping lines and curves instead of hard and boxy lines. The back end is where Hyundai hasn't done much work. Yes, they have tweaked the taillight design a little and they've switched up the bumper, but still, it's pretty similar to the last gen Verna, but it does not look bad at all.
Pop into the interiors and at the first glance, you actually won't see a lot of differences. But it's actually when you start observing the little tweaks that Hyundai have done to perfect this interior. They've changed this whole middle section, and instead of the puny little infotainment screen that you used to get, you get a big infotainment screen. And yeah, of course, you get all of the latest gubbins like Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, and you also get wireless charging now. But the biggest difference has happened here, in front of the driver. Instead of analog tachometers and speedometers, you get a digital dash. It's inspired by BMW because you have the counterclockwise and clockwise speedometer and tachometer, and it looks really, really cool. So the engine in this car is a 1.5 turbocharged diesel, and it makes a modest 113 bhp, but it makes an astonishing 250 newton meters of torque. So when you downshift, it actually pulls quite hard. There's no problem in pulling power. It's very powerful. Overtakes are super easy to do in this car because the torque is laid out all over the rev range and you don't have a problem anytime. But the thing is, this isn't a driver's car, so you shouldn't drive it like that. It's not meant to be grabbed by the scruff of its neck and hammered down the road. Instead, it's meant to go easily with a lot of creature comforts with you. And when you're talking about creature comforts, well, this car has quite a few.
You get cruise control, wireless charging, heated and ventilated seats, a decently sized sunroof. You get a backup camera with a DRVM driving function which shows cars around you while driving. And you get much more. The suspension is super smooth and it is one of the best suspension setups that you can get in this price range. The steering wheel is not heavy at all. In fact, it's one of the lightest steering wheels I've ever driven. The gearbox and clutch are super easy to find out and are super easy to put into place easily, and you won't have trouble finding the slots for the gearbox.
Hyundai has really stepped up their game in the compact sedan segment, and this new Verna is showing that they're here to stay, and it's a serious competitor. It goes against cars like the Vento Highline, the Toyota Yaris, and also the newly launched Honda City. And well, yeah, the Vento can be specced with the automatic transmission, but you're getting a car which is essentially 10 years old. Whereas this, you get new grills, new headlamps, new infotainment systems, a new digital cluster, and so much more. And well, about the new Honda City, well, we haven't driven it, so we can't say anything solid about it. But when it comes to the Verna, it is a serious car in this segment. So thank you so much for watching this video. Like, share and subscribe. Tell us what you think about the new Verna. Do you think it's a better car than any of the other competitors in its segment? Let us know in the comments down below. And before you sign off, do check out Garve Hyundai.
Garve Hyundai is quite possibly one of the largest Hyundai dealerships in Pune, and their service centers and showrooms are spread across all over. They have a lot of cool features inside their showrooms, like a digital kiosk which has virtual reality and other cool quizzes for Hyundai customers. Their staff is super polite, so if you're in the market to buy a Hyundai, please do check Garve Hyundai out.